So now I like to prove the reconvergence of the Euler scheme using Itô's lemma and the Feynman-Katz theorem. So we discussed time discretization of the stochastic processes, and here you see again the Euler scheme. That was the definition we had in the beginning of the section on time discretizations. So if you have dx is mu dt plus sigma dw, then Euler scheme just gives you a sequence of random variables at different discretization times ti. And in order to actually define or prove the convergence, we had to actually work a little bit. So the weak convergence compares two stochastic processes. So here you see again the definition of the weak convergence, which we already had in one of the last sessions. So you fix a certain time, here it's little t, and you have some test functions. And for all such times within your finite time horizon from zero to capital T, and for all Lipschitz continuous test functions, you compare the expectation of f of x of t with the expectation of f of x tilde, which is the Euler scheme approximation of t. And you have that the expectation of f of the Euler scheme approximation converges to the expectation of f of the true stochastic process evaluated at little t if the time discretization goes to zero. So that was actually the more important part here in the definition of the weak convergence. We can define the order of the convergence. So we have an estimate of the difference of these two expectations in terms of the biggest time step size used in the time discretization. Okay, so that was our setup in the last session. And in order now to prove the convergence, we had to redefine a little bit the Euler scheme, namely make the Euler scheme also a time continuous stochastic process. And the definition was quite easy, so it is here. So the Euler scheme approximation is actually the stochastic process which you get. So it is dx tilde is mu tilde dt plus sigma tilde dw when you take piecewise constant coefficients. And the piecewise constant coefficient, so defined here on the interval from ti to ti plus one, is given by mu tilde is mu evaluated at the starting point time, evaluated at the starting point of the last previous Euler step. So the end point of the previous Euler step. And the same for the sigma. Okay, so that was our setup. So we made the Euler scheme stochastic process an Itô process with piecewise constant coefficients. And then we can now consider this type of convergence. And you already see here that what we like to do is an expectation of f, a function, applied to the stochastic process at a certain time. So actually this really smells like Itô's lemma and Feynman-Katz theorem, because both do something like this. The Itô's lemma tells us what is the stochastic process if I apply a function to another stochastic process. And Feynman-Katz even goes one step further and tells us how does the conditional expectation of this evolve, yeah, if we go backward. Okay, so we discussed Itô's lemma and Feynman-Katz theorem. And we have some intuition for this. So now let's prove the weak convergence of the Euler scheme. I assume that the initial value is deterministic, and mu and sigma are sufficiently smooth. So the requirements from mu and sigma will pop out later in the proof. Then you have that the Euler scheme approximation converges to the true solution of the stochastic process with weak order one. Yeah? So we have here convergence with weak order one. So what I need to do is I need to prove the estimate that the difference of the expectation of the function applied to X true solution at some given time minus expectation of function applied to Euler scheme approximation at that given time, that this distance is smaller than a constant, which can depend on the time, so on our time horizon times H. Okay. I used the notation, which I had quickly reviewed from our last session. So I used just the tilde for the Euler scheme approximation and the X for the true solution. And let's consider this function from the Feynman-Katz theorem, which is the conditional expectation, given that we started in little t and little x with our stochastic process. So our stochastic process starts in little t with the initial value x. Take then the expectation of f of x at capital T. Then from the Feynman-Katz theorem, you have that u is the solution of actually this PDE here. So you have that if we define this u here, then this is the solution of this PDE. So this PDE goes backward in time. So the PDE goes backward. In time from a terminal condition okay. So what's the terminal condition here? So the terminal condition is already here implicitly in our definition here. So we had here f of x of t. So from actually the terminal condition u at capital T is just the function f. Yeah? So because if you take conditional expectation of f of x of t, given that f x of capital T starts in little x at time capital T, then the stochastic process, there's nothing to do for it. And the value at of u at the end is just f. Okay. For times before, so maybe I draw again the graph, So for times before, u is the conditional expectation. So let's draw again this little picture here. So we have here some time. So this is now the time capital T where we have this function f. Yeah? So there's here f of x. And we start with our stochastic process at some point here, u of t and x. So we start here with some point with the stochastic process. And we define the function to be the conditional expectation condition that we started there. So let's write this down. Yeah. So u of t and x is the value expectation of f of x of t. Okay, so maybe I don't write the conditional expectation here inside. I write it here so it works, yeah, so written down. Given that x started in little t and x, yeah, so this means x of little t is equal to x, little x. Yeah? So given that you started there. And now comes a really brilliant idea. What starting point should we use? So actually t and x is just here a two-dimensional plane. And for x, I plug in now a random variable. So u is a function of two arguments, t and little x. But if for little x, I plug in a random variable, then u of this random variable will become a random variable. And since we have u for different times, the u becomes a stochastic process. And the brilliant idea, what we plug in for the little x, what random variable we plug in, is the Euler approximation at this time little t. So here is the time little t. And now you start at your initial value here, and you do the Euler approximation. So I illustrate the Euler approximation maybe with a few discrete passes here. And you have different sample passes. Okay, and one sample pass here will maybe hit this point. And then we start from there with the Feynman-Katz simulation, take the conditional expectation. Here from above, we will maybe start with a different one. Yeah, so there will be a different one here starting here. Okay, so you take the Euler scheme up to time little t, and from the endpoint, you use the correct solution. Crazy idea. So the idea, we start in t and x tilde of t. Yeah. So note here, this is a random variable. Okay, so this means that now the function t maps to u of little t and x tilde of little t is a stochastic process. Okay, this is a strange stochastic process. So what happens if you change the time little t? The function u takes the conditional expectation, so the expectation if you start at this point. If you move little t to zero, what do we get? So if we move little t to zero, u of zero, then the Euler scheme starts at the same initial value as true solution x. Yeah? So actually, we start in x tilde of zero, but x tilde of zero is the same as x of zero. Yeah? Then this is just the expectation of simulate the true stochastic process to the end and take the expectation. So it's just the expectation of f of x of t. So now move little t to the other side. Yeah. So move little t to the other side to capital T. What do we get then? So it's the light blue the Euler scheme simulates to the end, and you take just the conditional expectation of the endpoint. Conditional expectation of the endpoint is just the point itself. So if you move to capital T, x tilde of capital T, then we just get f at x tilde capital T. So there's no expectation because it's just expectation of a point. So expectation of f of x of t, conditional that x of t is x tilde of t, is just expectation of x tilde of t. But given that we are at this final point, so it's just the final point. Okay, so this is a funny thing. And if you now take the expectation of u, you see expectation of expectation is again expectation. But expectation of f of x tilde of t is expectation of f of x tilde of t. So you see that the expectation of u connects the true solution expectation with the Euler scheme expectation. So this function u is just an interpolation between these two guys here. This is just an interpolation between these two parts in my Feynman cut, in my weak convergence estimate. So now I have a stochastic process, which on the one side has the expectation of the true solution, and on the other side has a random variable. When I take the expectation, it's the expectation of the Euler scheme solution, with our test function. So our weak convergence now maybe claims that if I add up all the changes from u, when I go to from left to right, if I add them all up, they stay small. So u at capital T minus u at zero, this reminds you maybe of something. It's the integral from zero to capital T over du, over the changes of u. So the next thing is u is a stochastic process. Let's apply Itô's lemma to it. What does it look like? So u is a stochastic process. We can apply Itô's lemma. And what does u look like? So u is a function of x tilde of t. It's the application of Itô's lemma. So next step is that we apply Itô's lemma to this function u. U of x tilde of t. And there is a magic here. So remember Itô's lemma, you get du is some coefficient times the derivative of the function which you apply. And the coefficients here are now the one that belong here to the Euler scheme. So I plugged in the Euler scheme stochastic process. U is just a function. So the coefficients that pop out here are those of the Euler scheme, not those of the true solution. Okay, so we apply Itô's lemma to the differential. So we have the differential applied to U and use Itô's lemma. So I have here the differential. So we get Itô's lemma du by dt plus mu, the mu from the Euler scheme, mu tilde du by dx plus 1/2 sigma, the sigma from the Euler scheme. So sigma tilde squared, second derivative of u. So that is the guy in front of the dt. So Itô's lemma gives us a dt and a dw. Okay, so, and I already motivated, this is what Itô's lemma gives us for the du, and the difference, so which is of interest to us, is what is the difference between u at the endpoint, capital T, and u at the beginning point, zero? Yeah, because one is the expectation of the true solution, the other one is not yet the expectation, but f of the Euler scheme approximation. If we take expectation of this, we have our result. Okay, and hopefully this function u, which connects the two random variables, yeah, the f of the true solution and the f of the Euler scheme, hopefully this u does not have big changes, yeah, because I would like to have the Euler close to the true solution. And hopefully the changes are small because we are integrating them. So how can we proceed? So you see that here you have du by dt. Okay, and this tells us how does the function u change over time. And up to this line it's just Itô's lemma, but here comes now the definition, the special definition of u into play. Use how u was defined. Yeah, u was this function which you got from the Feynman-Katz theorem. And the Feynman-Katz theorem told us that du by dt, so the way how u changes, is related to du by dx and the second derivative of u by dx squared. Yeah, so this one, okay? So I can now use this PDE to replace du by dt by minus mu du by dx plus minus 1/2 sigma squared second derivative of u with respect to x. Okay, so I can replace here the du by dt with this expression. And this now gives you a difference between the coefficient which comes from the Euler scheme and the coefficient that comes from the Feynman-Katz theorem. So maybe I take a green color here, yeah, to distinguish this, or some other color. So maybe I use here also a green color because it was a green box, yeah. So we use here how u was defined. Yeah, so how u was defined, namely here in this green box. Okay, so we use that to replace the u with this expression, which gives us here always a difference between the coefficient from the true stochastic process and the coefficient from the Euler scheme approximation. The same for the sigma. Okay. And for a small time step size, these two coefficients, they are also evaluated at similar arguments. Yeah. So the first one is just at the starting interval. The other one is in between the interval. They should be close. Okay. There is a last thing left here. Since this is a stochastic process and the Feynman-Katz is just a PDE. Yeah. So there's still here this guy, the stochastic integral. Okay, there's still the dw part. Okay, but recall that here in this thing, I was telling you our u, where we plug in the Euler scheme, is a stochastic process which starts at this value. Yeah, the conditional, the expectation is just a value, and which ends in this random variable. Yeah, so it ends in this random variable. And we can still take the expectation of this. Yeah? So we take the expectation of this difference here. If we take the expectation of this difference here, then we take the expectation of the whole expression here and the expectation of the whole expression here. And the expectation of this here is zero because this is a martingale. The dw part will go away. Okay, so that's the last step. So we take expectation and we get rid of this guy. Taking expectation, we have that u at the starting point, so u at time zero, was just the expectation of f of x of t with the true solution of the stochastic process. So expectation of expectation just remains this. This is here. So that was maybe some green color for the starting point. It's the part here for the true stochastic process. And now if we take expectation, the u at the endpoint was a random variable, namely f of x tilde of t. And taking expectation is expectation of f of x tilde of capital T. So these are exactly this is exactly the difference we like to estimate. Okay, so this is the expectation of the integral or the integral over time of the expectations of the difference of the coefficients from the Euler scheme approximation and the true stochastic process. And this is now very similar to what you had for the strong convergence. Yeah. That was with the squared or we achieved something like this after we have squared the stuff. So that was why we get only order 1/2. So, but this is now very, very similar. We have an expectation of the difference of the coefficients with the strong convergence. There was a supremum involved. Here it's not, it's just the integral over time. So since the Euler scheme coefficients are piecewise constant, we decompose now the integral into a sum. So the integral here is replaced by a sum. Yeah. Over smaller intervals, just corresponding to the time step size. Then we can plug in the Euler scheme coefficient definition. It's just u tilde of ti. So u tilde of ti is just mu. It's just mu tilde of little t is then just mu of ti x tilde of ti. Okay, and you can just estimate these by a constant times the time steps size h. So I don't go into detail here. Yeah, it's like what we had before. So if you sum this up over all those intervals, yes, you integrate over the dt, you get another factor. It's a factor time. So actually you can here write if you integrate, this here is just a capital T. So actually I could also on the right hand side write 2c times t times h. And we have our estimate that the difference is estimated by the time step size h times a constant. The constant depends on the time horizon over which you simulate. And maybe having seen this proof, this is also some information. The approximation error of the Euler scheme, we would expect that it grows over time, at least with the time, linear in time. Yeah? Because here you see there is, in this estimate we have here, it could be better, but in our estimate we have some capital T. So maybe we can do some numerical experiments in another session to check for this. How does the Euler scheme approximation behave if you let the time running? Yeah. So actually the behavior could be worse because we also do not know if the coefficient, how the coefficient behaves. Yeah. But if you have your, for example, Lipschitz condition on the coefficient, then you can check some behavior also with respect to the time. Okay, so I believe that was it. Let me check. Taking expectation. Yeah, that was it. Yeah, that's the proof of the weak conversions. A very nice application of Feynman-Katz and Ito. And also we had a nice review of Ito and Feynman-Katz, which are both interesting in for themselves in creating numerical methods. So thanks. That was it for this session. And we will have some code sessions coming up next, where we can now practice a little bit with stochastic processes, combining Monte Carlo and stochastic processes.